Okay, let's move on to the next one. And next is who? What is this? Forgot, man. Tyron Woodley versus Jake Paul. Man, hats off to this Jake Paul guy. Oof. Unbelievable. I mean, not as talented and successful as his brother, but he really is doing whatever it takes to be in the limelight. I mean, the Paul brothers, they are relevant only because they make themselves relevant. You know, like they say, famous for the sake of being famous. Like you have Kim Kardashian. Why are they famous? Famous for the sake of being famous. Showing your boobs, your ass, naked, and Instagram perfect shots. And then you get the sheep-minded people who worship them as gods. And then you get the desperate men who, if they see boobs and vagina, they, oh. I know so many of them, so many of characters like this. No matter, like I told you, I have this WhatsApp group which is filled with porn. Oh, it never ends. I don't know, I don't even check. But every day I have to clear 500 videos and 500 bloody images and, oh my God, she's so hot and this and that. The amount of desperation that is there is like, oof. I'm not trying to hate on them or not trying to say, oh, I'm better than them, but okay, fine. When you're horny and all that, but every single day, every single bloody, there are some for them, this is addiction. Anyway, so we have this Jake Paul who knocked out Ben Askren, which was a shocker. Personally, I felt it was a rigged, this thing, because Ben, the amount of, anyway, he was retired. He had his surgery, his time was up. He looked, just looked like a sack of wheat, or, you know, you just put water in a plastic bag. He looked like that, totally out of shape. And the money he made fighting Jake Paul was more than all his fights put together. All. I mean, he must have made nearly 1 million or something, or half a million, whatever. I'm pretty sure 1 million with pay-per-view buys and all that. Yes, he has to pay taxes, he has to pay his trainers, he has to pay his team and everything else. End of the day, he has a family to feed and life to look after. So he has had a stellar career. Nothing but respect him. He was in the Olympics. He has had his glory days. So today, it doesn't matter if he's famous or not. I'm 100% sure he threw that fight away. 100%. This is me, my gut feeling. Okay. So now you have Tyron Woodley. Tyron Woodley, if you check, this MMA fighter was an MMA, I mean, he was like a legend. He's built like a, unbelievable, like a cartoon character with muscles. So he had his peak and he was unstoppable and every guy was destroying them. But then he started his nonsense. He started his distractions, rap album and he acted with Salman Khan in a movie, huh? As a villain. He acted, Tyron Woodley actually acted with Salman Khan as a fighter in, as a villainous character in a movie. And, you know, then he got brainwashed with this Black Lives Matter movement. You can just Google search Tyron Woodley interview, Black Lives Matter. Every question that is being asked, hi Tyron, what do you think of this new fight? He would just answer, Black Lives Matter. Okay. Do you feel that you have a chance to win? Black Lives Matter. That's the only answer he kept giving. I was like, what the fuck is wrong with this guy? Okay, what was your training program like? Black Lives Matter. Chutia Giri, man, number one. He anyway lost the fight. Good. That was, you lost the fight, Black Lives Matter. He should have said that. And then he stopped his nonsense after that. But ever since that, he kept losing each and every fight. Every fight, he kept losing. He didn't win any fight after that. And 4 fights in a row and he got cut out by the UFC. Now, when Jake Paul, he was getting ready to fight Ben Askren backstage, Tyron Woodley was the, you know, the support group or the team that was preparing Ben Askren. So Jake Paul started to taunt Jake Paul and his team or his boxers started to disrespect Tyron Woodley. So Tyron said, I'll knock your fucking lights out and this and that. Obviously, fighters, hot blood. So that, I think Tyron, he's an intelligent guy. He knew that, okay, I can make this ball roll. And he started to hype it up on social media. I'll destroy Jake Paul and this and that, and started taunting him. And Jake Paul, obviously, he wanted the MMA community to hate on him, so his popularity becomes trending. They started, and but what I was shocked about is Jake Paul actually wanting to fight him. The Showtime, just imagine, such a big brand like Showtime, they signed him up. That's hats off to Jake Paul. He's hardly in his 20s and he's doing what we guys can never dream of doing. Impossible. He's that much of a genius. You got Showtime to sign him up for a multi-fight contract. And lo and behold, he has actually agreed to fight this guy. Now, I can tell you one thing. He will prepare. He will really work hard. He will really practice. From diet to exercise to everything else. 100%. They will do it perfectly. But, you know where the problem will happen? The problem is, we don't know whether this fight is rigged or real. Because, think about it. These guys are fighters from the day they start their career. This guy is a YouTuber. How can you expect anyone to believe that a person who is born to fight and who is dedicated whole life to fighting will get knocked out by a young boy who is not even spend 20% or 10% of the experience of fighting? Now, I can tell you this much. If Tyron Woodley loses, 100% it is rigged, no matter what anyone says. And if he gets knocked out, Tyron Woodley's reputation will spoil, but I'm pretty sure if it happens, it's obvious that he took at least 1 million under the table cash just to throw the fight. Because I don't believe Tyron Woodley will lose if he puts his 100%. But then again, what do I know? So you guys tell me if you believe Tyron Woodley versus Jake Paul, is it a legit fight? Because, yeah, one hand, Jake Paul is selecting his opponents. But will Tyron Woodley win? If he wins, it's the end of the hype train for Jake Paul. Everyone wants that. But if Tyron Woodley loses and Jake Paul wins, man, fuck, it's going to be a furore. It's going to be a furore. His stock will climb up anyhow, but there will always be, did he throw this fight? So that's another thing. So you tell me. Oh, snake over. You tell me, who do you think will win? Okay.
Jesus. Hello there. It's me, Jesus Christ, speaking to you from heaven. All right, you? Yeah, you, my friend. Yeah, you. Look, you prayed to me every single day, and you told me, like, I want a better paying job, and I want to, like, change my life, and I want to be happy. Well, look, here's your answer. Contact my buddy, Loy Macedo, of loymacedo.com, and he will do the needful. Well, okay. Maybe he looks like the devil. Maybe a little scary, you know, the tattoos, you know, slightly horrible, but, like, trust me, like, okay, he looks terrible, right, but don't worry, he's a cool guy. So, what are you waiting for? Google him, Google his name, contact him, yeah, and you'll see why I sent you. Yeah, he's the real deal. And yes, my child, you'll find the answer. You know, this is the part where you stop staring at me and contact the guy. All right. Trust me, Go on now. I got other things to do around here, all right?